So I was all like, yo, man, you shouldn't make me move over there. And the commander was all like, yo, do that. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you? That's right in front of an alien, and I can't shoot, and he can shoot me. And the commander was all like, you'll be fine. This guy's gonna get us fucking killed. Yeah! With me! Welcome back to XCOM, where guys are injured. But it's not as bad as it was. There's only a couple. Okay, there's a few. These guys are about to get out. Li Wei Ye and our support, our one medic... One, let me not understate how bad that is for us. The next mission we do, we're going to have to send a bunch of squaddies with medkits to try to turn them into medics. And that means we're going to go under-equipped and under-prepared. But they've all come back to active duty, so good stuff there. And we've completed alien material research, and our excavation is complete, so good stuff happening. Nanofiber vest available for manufacture. This will give them a little bit more hit points, but... It unlocks the Carapace Armor Tech Tree, which will take a million years to research. So we're not going to go there right away. I think we're going to go with weapon fragments.
Though I do not always agree with Dr.
And let's see here. How far away is... Oh no, the council report's 3 days away. Shit. It takes a few days for a satellite to get to a country. So I don't know if this is going to work right, but... We're going to deploy a satellite over probably South Africa right now. Because we don't really want the We Have Ways bonus. And we wouldn't get very much from launching over any of these other places. And South Africa is panicked as fuck, so let's launch our satellite there. It's 5 day travel time. I thought it was 4. Well, we did kind of screw that up. Satellite coverage over one third of the countries in Africa... One engineer per month. Oh, don't worry, I'll take care of that. Their panic level goes way down, and we still don't have the all-in bonus, but that's okay. So we'll go view the ship list, and we will transfer you to Africa. Africa. Takes 3 days to transit, no big deal. Hopefully that will help us. Let's take a look at the finances. Okay, that already did increase our funding. So, as the report comes up, which should be very soon here, we're going to have to be reporting to council. What is this? This is not a cutscene I remember. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's because when you play through the game on normal with the tutorial on, it just gives you the officer training school. So there we go, we've got our officer training school, and that is insanely important, and I will show you why. Officer training school, squad size 2, wet work, 25% experience gained from kills, new guy, new soldiers are automatically promoted to rookie, rapid recovery, they heal twice as fast, don't higher soldiers ranked more likely to be critically wounded instead of killed, and iron will, a will bonus each time they are promoted. So, we want to get all of these up as soon as possible, even though we can't afford that. Anyway, let's go on to the council meeting.
We are extremely impressed with the progress of the XCOM project thus far, Commander.
Thanks, bro.
Your recent results
we got an A.
are beyond our expectations.
Fuck yeah.
And that is not a statement this council makes lightly.
It makes it heavily? Alright, so we got an extra scientist, an extra engineer. 255 was our reward. We did, things would show up in red here if we fucked them up. So, we completed a council mission, we shot down a UFO, we stopped 2 abductions, we launched a satellite, we completed a bunch of research projects, and we raided a UFO. So all good stuff there, but again, it's very early on. And so yeah, we're getting 80 from South Africa, 100 from Germany, and that's pretty much it. But we did get a pretty big bonus. Cool, man. You keep watching. We got $152. Straight to the officer training school. Squad size plus 1, please. We need that. We absolutely need that. Now, facilities. Shut up. Okay, we've got new engineers. Good for us. Oh, we're going to need everything. Yeah. The way we're going to have to do this is we're going to have to build the alien containment. And then we're going to have to build... power generator, and then we're going to have to build a satellite uplink, and then and only then will we be able to afford to build labs and workshops. Although we do have bonuses to their upkeep, and they're very cheap because of who we are. But not cheap enough. So let's start the alien containment. Wait, is this where I want it? No, but not really. Actually, that's not bad at all. Yeah, we'll put it there. We'll just toss it in the corner. Right next to the officer training school, so the aliens can learn our officer-y ways. We don't have any money, which sucks, because we need to build arc throwers. So, will you shut up? So, with that in mind, we're going to go sell some sectoids. It's fine, we've got tons of them. There's 20, we don't need that many. If we put financial gains Shut up. Research and development. You let me do the commanding. I'm the fucking commander here. Okay, that costs 23. We have enough to build two of them. How much does it cost to make a nanofiber vest? Oh, let's make one and then a nanofiber. Can I make two? Yeah. Alright, cool. Now we have two nanofiber vests, an arc thrower, we have way more to do with equipping our soldiers. And look at it, everybody's off medbay! Yes! The only one I really, really, really need to make sure, this guy's got a med kit. Excellent. And let's see here, everybody else has got... Let's give... Rowdy's kind of an amazing bro, so why don't we give him the arc thrower?
Bring one of those things back here with the arc thrower, Commander. We're going to need a containment facility to house...
I'm building it. Actually, he's got a point. This will give him an extra 2 hit points, and so I guess I'll do that. And I'm not willing to give up grenades on anybody else right now. He will be our arc thrower, though. Because he's the rowdiest one we have. Alright, so there we go. Nobody else has got a nickname yet. Everybody's off of their stuff, but the next mission we're going to need to take... at least one rookie with us to try to get them to be a support squaddy. What's this room? I've never looked at this room before. What happens in here? Numbers. Numbers and gigantic pencils! Those are huge novelty pencils! Look at the, they're the size of the fucking post on this chair! I want one. And there's a picture of a blur! what a great room. Okay, so this is the officer training room. I guess. Okay. This is going to be our alien containment facility, and we are excavating here, I believe. Yeah, okay. So the officer training school does not look anything like an officer training school, but whatever. Awesome! Let's pass some time! Ship transfer completed. Satellite's operational, everything's ready to go over Africa, and we've researched weapon fragments. Goody goody gumdrops. Now we can put a scope on someone, which is okay. I don't really like that particular one. But it allows us to research beam weapons, which is okay, again, but I think what I want to do... don't thin men... I forget what researching thin men gives you. I thought it had something to do with med kits. No, that's just for the foundry, I think. I really, really gotta do this. This needs to happen right away, but 24 days? I feel like we could probably do some more... I feel like I'm mismanaging my research a little bit here, but I don't know what else to do. It's tough, the situation we're in. We can't afford to build anything, really. Alright, there's our alien containment facility. Cool stuff. Alright, where is it? Let's go look. It is over here. There's the thingy. That's where the aliens go, and then squish them, and they die. After we contain them for a minute. And now we're down to one interceptor. All alone. So sad. But I do like that they display that stuff. I think that's pretty cool. Okay, so everyone's on active duty. Why are these guys in the med bay if they're not injured? Fucking weirdos. What? Nothing to do there. Let's go here and scan. Ooh, abductions. This is something we're going to do. We need money. That much is for sure. Support sergeant. That one is so tough to pass up. We need scientists and this place is panicky as shit. Canada, they're fine. What are the aliens going to do in Canada? And ski? No, wait, there's not that much... Well, no, there's snow. It's just flat, so skiing doesn't really work. I'm so fucking mean. Alright. So we could go invade Manchester to get $200. But I think we're going to end up going to China for scientists in order to try and reduce the panic of this place, because it's panicky as shit. If it panics anymore, it's going to fucking go out of control. But we do have 5 people to do this with. And these are all people who have got promotions. So I think what I'm going to do is we're going to have Rowdy here for sure. Don't need 2-3 snipers. No, I do not need that. What are you? Are, do you have snapshot? Okay, you can come. Nakamakam Fubudu Boo Boo, you can come too. And let's take the Stig. Sweet. And we'll take Maximilian. And I want to put a med kit on you. And frag, nanofiber med kit. Let's take the med kit off of whoever has the other one. Yeah. Sorry. You're not going on the mission, you're too important. And we'll put it on, who was gonna go? Oh no, we had the sniper, Zoe. And then we're gonna put another med kit on the Stig. Alright, so only 2 frag grenades. Not super thrilled about that. Those have been a fucking primary to my killing potential, but we do have a rocket launcher to augment them. So hopefully that will work. This is what we're gonna take, no matter what. All the way to, where are we? Oh yeah, China, the hard one. Blech. Operation Blind Crone. Another dangerous sounding one. Looks like we're invading a McDonald's in China. Alrighty. Hey, he didn't park us next to the gas station. Thumbs up, pilot. I thought I saw a gas station out here somewhere. Maybe it's out here somewhere. I don't know, I can't see it. Okie dokie. So, we've got a lot of people here, including Rowdy. Where's the Stig? There's the Stig. Alright, Stig. This car is half cover. They're all half cover. There's no good car. And this car has a... Somebody was going through the drive-thru and was like, fuck that, I don't want to order any alien sandwiches. You're gonna over our watch. Rowdy, you are so strong. How did you get so strong? Go stand by the 24 sign. Ooh, you stood too. Uh-oh.
It's hard to differentiate where the organic material ends and the machine begins.
That's not good.
That's for sure.
It's very not good. Let's move one of our beef kebabs up closer. Koenig, I don't know anything about you. I'd like to put him in Overwatch, but there's no way to get him close enough and also in cover to go into Overwatch, so we're just going to have him run here. There's some cover there, and it's not too exposed. And you, I want over here. Alright, let's get this cracking. Don't do that. I don't like it when you do that. They have the ability to relocate anywhere on the map, but it takes their whole turn to do it. We've got some anorexics. We have a lot of anorexics. Oh my goodness. And they're all right next to each other. Oh no, they're gonna split up now. No, come back. No. I was gonna give you a vegan rocket to the face. Okay, so first problem is this floaty guy. Not the best percent chance, if I may say so myself. But we could deal with this the Jeff fashioned way. Just stroll right up to him. 58%, not strong enough. The only thing I'm worried about is that guy. I think if I move here, he'll be in good cover and still be able to get a really high percent chance on the... Are you kidding me? There's a lot of fucking aliens here. I dig it. I am defecating in my pants right now. What the hell just happened? You can't get close enough to lob a grenade. Oh, you don't even have a grenade. Oh, Rowdy. You can take care of this guy. Run and gun, man. We'll do it. Oh, God, you can't. Well, you can. Yeah. I'm not gonna take no 82% this time. No fucking sir. Perdona me. Yeah, that's right. That's what I thought. Okie dokie. Move up here and go into Overwatch. You should be able to get a shot on. So, you never mind. You can shoot now. That's a lot of people. Why don't you hunker down? And our sniper is predictably fucking useless. Still fucking useless. Oh, now you get into range. Okie dokie. You can go here. Hopefully get a shot on someone or something. 45%, that's not bad. Sure, why not? Good job, Stig. Oh my god. This mission is gonna go really bad. And so it begins with a miss! I count 8, and I'm not seeing all of them. He's got no cover at all, so everything's gonna hit. 6 fucking damage? That wasn't even a critical. Spat poison on my sniper. So, good for you. Oh, okay, he missed. But blew up his cover. Oh my god. He just one-shotted our heavy. Fucking XCOM. This mission is dead. Because he was carrying our rocket launcher. Oh no, and he's dead too. No, he's got one. Oh, he's critically wounded. Okay. So we're left with 3. One of them is completely useless. That being our sniper. Who's poisoned and slowly dying. It'll wear off after a little while. These two are competitively useless as a profession. They have med kits, so they can get over there and do something about Rowdy, but not without dying. Do you have any amazing shots? Look at our sniper. Such a great chance to hit. And such great movement ability, too. Get out of the poison, stupid. 1%! 1%! Why is the game just taking a shit on my face right now? Like, it was going so well. And now it's just like, hey, you've got a face. Why don't I shit all over it? Alright, Koenig's got the most hit points, so he's gonna stay. He's gonna be hanging and banging. And you are... Ugh, fuck. I really wish these guys had grenades. There's like 8 aliens right here, so if I go anywhere near Rowdy, I don't want him to die, but there's no point. I can't fucking save him. Just go here, I guess. At least get in position. The possibility of saving will be not impossible. This looks like better cover than what you're in. It's gonna cost you to get there. What?
Come on, game. That is just not even okay. And the car is gonna explode, so I have to move him again. XCOM? I see what you're doing here. I see what you're doing here. You're giving me the opportunity for a heroic comeback. Everything is gonna go my way in just a moment, right? Right? Surely. Surely it will. No one else is gonna die. We're gonna kill all these aliens in a explosive and dramatic finale. Will not end up backfiring in our fucking faces. Oh, goody. Okay, so she's poisoned, and the car she's next to is on fire. And that one exploded. This guy's got one hit point left, so I don't move him. He's dead. Everything is fucked. Oh, and she can't move to any cover that's not this car. I just thought I'd point that out for you. Why is her movement so bad? One, two, three. She can move three. Yeah, one, two, three, four. Okay, so four at the most. She's the worst person ever. Well, we need you to throw a grenade, because you're only the only one that has one, and you have a possibility of... Actually, no. You can only hurt them. You can't kill them, because they've got four hit points on Classic, as opposed to three on Normal. So this will just slightly injure them. Goody. You've got a 65% chance to very slightly damage that guy. Swell. Why would it go any other way? He's got a great chance to hit a whole bunch of people that don't matter. This guy's almost dead. Shoot him. Sure. Heck. At least you did something before you died. Oh, no. Please, no. Oh, now you take cover, you stupid bitch. Where is evac? Yeah, I saw that one coming. Okay, so we got one left. For now. He may not survive the turn. He didn't! Fuck you, XCOM! Are you serious? Just... absolutely laid waste to my entire squad. That was just a series of slightly bad luck, you know? And extreme outnumberedness. Yeah, panic in China. We're in danger of losing them in the count. We're not in danger of it. We have lost them, because there's nothing we can do. We can't build a satellite nexus, so we can't build any more satellites, and we can't deploy any more satellites. Well, goody. Situation room is showing. China is all red. And we don't have any uplinks, so nothing we can do there. We don't have any money, so nothing we can do there. This, my friends, is the beginning of the end of XCOM. We all knew it was coming. Let's just deal. I don't think that there... I think that we just were dealt a shit hand with that battle. None of our shots hit. And the alien spawn locations were just sort of... really, really bad for us. And they got a couple of lucky shots, like that critical shot on my heavy. You know, there you go. There's half my AoE damage potential taken out in one shot. This is how quickly it turns, and here is what we've got left. No one was injured. They all died. Let's go visit the memorial. A lot more pictures of dead people. And some of them were pretty good too, including Rowdy. He only had 3 kills, but he was still pretty rowdy. And this guy didn't even have a name and he had 7 kills. Oh, that's right, because he came pre-made. And Zoe, who was our horrible, horrible sniper. The worst sniper ever. And Max, who never did anything. And Stig, who was the Stig? He never even got to drive a car. There's been a lot of drinking going on, and I can't blame them. Except that we need their livers for future operations, so they should stop that right now.